Number 15 is Miami.
How fun was it to see Miami in a spread offense where they use their athletes in space and throw it around? It all revolves around the king. If the king is healthy and makes it through week one through Alabama, they'll be a fun team to watch. But Rhett Lashley had that offense humming a year ago.
LSU comes in at number 14, Joey.
Yeah, this surprises me to see LSU this high because of the season they had last season. I expect them to be better, don't get me wrong. Their defense has to be better. Defensively, they look lost.
It can't get worse
in
though,
a lot
Joey.
Of games. They were terrible on the defensive side.
I'm going to ask you guys about the new coordinators as well in just a moment. Number 13 is USC. Keaton Slovis is back quarterback.
I mean, in Graham Harrell's offense, they're going to pitch it around. I tell you what, Drake London will be a breakout superstar at wide receiver. This offense is going to put up a ton of numbers. He doesn't have the rocket arm, but he's going to throw it a lot and put up sick, insane numbers.
Listen, we know who's not playing for Florida this year. All the offensive talent, they still have talent everywhere. They come in at number 12.
They're going to have to run the ball better this season. Last season, they threw it so well with Pitts, Kadarius Toney, and Kyle Trask at quarterback that they didn't have a 100-yard rusher in any game. They got to run the ball at Florida.
Since he's number 11.
Desmond Ridder. I mean, he's back again. It seems like he's been there for 100 years already, but put up great numbers, improved last year as a passer like crazy. Amon Gardner on the other side, one of the best corners in all of college football. Fickell's only gotten better at recruiting, and they're starting the season at 11.
You got Notre Dame on the schedule this year. Could be interesting, couldn't it? Hey, Florida I find very, very intriguing. Yes, Trask is gone. Pitts is gone. Kadarius Toney. So
Mullen's still there, though, right? Mullen's
still there.
Yeah, he's
and you
good.
Know what Mullen has in Emory Jones now at quarterback? He's got a quarterback who fits a lot of the profiles to how he's had success in the past. Emory Jones was a five-star. Emory Jones is a guy who's patiently waited his turn and was still getting playing time all the way through the process. Emory Jones could be a perfect fit for Dan Mullen.
Yeah, but you talk about like Kadarius Toney and Kyle Pitts. Like, yeah, those guys.
They got another one of those guys.
You don't find many Kyle Pitts anywhere.
Nobody does.
At any level. So it ain't just about quarterback. A, I believe that Florida will be a talented football team, but I do not think you can just say they lost some guys. They lost some real guys.
I get it.
That it's going to be hard to replace.
I get it. And I think their defense took a huge step back that last year, and especially personnel-wise, just not what we're used to seeing. But give me Cincinnati at 11. Mm-hmm. Why? Okay, if you're going to be a Power 5 team, you got to start high in the season. You go to Indiana this year. You go to Notre Dame. Desmond Ridder and company, all the starts, all the experience they have. The secondary will be really, really legit. Dude, Cincinnati could be a team that earns its way there. We talked about them last year. Joey was on board last year to try to get them in the college football playoff. Now they start with all that mojo, and starting at 11 is a big deal.
Let's talk about what version of LSU we're going to get. Of course, a couple of years ago, you know what you're getting, the best that you've ever seen. And then last year, 5-5, a lot of turmoil. Miles Brennan breaks his arm this summer, so Max Johnson's going to be the starting quarterback out of the gate. Boutte is still there at wide receiver. A lot of talent on defense that they've been recruiting well. Here's what I like about LSU. The two coordinator hires, Jake Peets as the offensive coordinator, Durante Jones as a defensive coordinator, because the scheme and the lineage by which they apply and come from connects back to 2019
with Aranda
and with Brady and the two other coordinators. They're getting back to what worked for them with these hires.
And they're staying in a 4-3, which last season they were switching from a 3-4 to a 4-3, which when you watch them, they just look like they had no idea what they were doing. I mean, there were so many busts on the defensive side. It's like, are they practicing at all? So they're going to stay at a 4-3 for a second year. So I do believe that this will be a different team. They have to build on the two upsets they got at the end of last season, got a couple wins, beating the Florida team we just talked about. They have to build on that. They're always talented, always athletic. If they can get into the right place where they're supposed to be on defense, they'll be pretty good.
Well, and it starts for me with Ricks and Stingley Jr. I mean, you got the best 1-2 punch at corner in the country. So, but last year you had a lot of talent and you had a lot of those guys, but the communication busts were, it was just ad nauseum. It was crazy to watch. So you expect Ed O to get that cleaned up. Listen, they got more dudes. I mean, more dudes just come to LSU. There's always a plethora of athletes, but they got to prove it. They definitely got to prove it on both sides of the football.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.